By the way, check this out. I like just the microphones with that. Just waiting, people waiting for questions. It's just one.
Is this your? It's a solo.
Can you please sing a song by Journey right now? Go ahead, start singing, sir.
Do it!
Let's do it right now!
story. So there's not any kind of variation or other worlds of Lex, and there's not, there's like, hey, you want to give me a shot at playing a badass that some people like, then I'll do it. You know, but some people, yeah. I mean, it was a great role, and I just don't want to lessen what I did. I'd rather, that's it.
The one thing for all three of you that you've seen as this, you know, overabundance of superhero genre stuff, it just seems that the reverence for what you guys did is a grand example. It seems like anytime you see an interview with any of the younger people, any of the people who have been involved in this, a lot of people owe a lot to the show. What about what this new wave of content has meant for the legacy of the show that you guys did?
You know, I think it's,
that was pretty intense, huh?
You know, I think it's, I'm honored by it, and I think everybody who, you know, all these people who are having successful shows in Arrow and Flash and all this, they don't owe us anything, you know, they're doing their own thing, and it's great, it's successful, they have millions and millions of fans. And what we did especially, I think this was before it all happened, this was a story before the story in many ways. So I think the cinematic approach to it, with the storytelling, with not making these kind of these caricatures and making wearing masks, it was really just, it was grounded as much as it could be. You know, we didn't do the tights or flights, and me not being evil and going, this is what I'm doing. It was just, you got to know why I became bad. And you got to know why I became bad. And it was a story that was unique. And so all these shows started like, oh, Smallville's successful, let's make a Flash, let's make an Arrow, let's make a Supergirl, let's make... We were the only one, really, that there was. So we're the first. So I take a lot. I think it's really cool. And there was no social media. We didn't have social media, so I think that helped us.
It was because of you guys.
It was you.
To be just a little serious, the timing is really everything. I mean, if you think about when your show premiered, it was a month after 9/11. And I remember living in New York during 9/11, and I remember, you know, working and knowing that there was a Superman show, but there wasn't a lot of details. Like I said, the internet was in its infancy, and just the idea that fans were looking for something heroic, not necessarily a hero, but something heroic. And by presenting that, even though Clark was still learning, it was definitely something where he had that integrity. He had, you could tell he had whatever intestinal fortitude it was that was going to make him the hero. And I just thought, the fact that you guys started in 2001 just was the ultimate time for your show.
And it was
just had to happen at that moment.
People needed that. People needed it. It was really good timing. You know, how many guys come up to us all the time, and women who served in the military, or, you know, went to Iraq, and they're like, and they're telling us that, like, hey, Smallville saved me. I'm like, God, that's, come on, how could Smallville save me? And they watched, yeah, and they watched with their platoon, and they, yeah, and it just, to me, it makes, like, I got goosebumps to do right now. It's just so amazing, like, you don't think that this can affect people, and it does. And then you see you guys come up, and some people cry, and, you know, we're blown away by it. It's powerful.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anything you want to add?
No,
that's good. Yeah. John, when you...
My
Michael
does have a heart.
John.
Michael does have a heart. And a very big one, just like Scott Michael. My boy. Call him everything he knows. And so.
This poor guy's already said. Are you guys mad at me asking this question or what? John, what are your memories of Smallville and playing Lionel? All these people know you as the great Lionel.
They come up and
Clark and Martha, I think Clark threw a party or something, and his parents came home and they were really upset. And there's a scene with just Martha and Clark, and she starts sort of talking about what was wrong, and all of a sudden, like, I started crying. And there was no crying in the scene. And we just went with it, and it turned out to be like a really cool scene, because it was very, you know, an embarrassed son, with it to, you know, being not scolded, but a mother explaining her disappointment. And that sucks.
You know, I think about it, I've said this, but I thank you and Andy Schneider and Annette, and just the way you guys were mentors. I mean, like, I love you, Tom.
It's true.
No, but seriously, you guys brought this weight to it. That sometimes we would have came into scenes thinking, all right, do this. And, you know, whether you touched me a certain way, or the way you spoke to me, or the way you presented the scene, it made us better actors. It made us engage more. Annette would make us vote more than you would.
And I think I learned from you and John and Annette accountability. Like, show up and do your work. And, like, I couldn't not be prepared with you guys. You know what I mean? And that's a testament to your career and how you guys treat the art. And that's, you know, looked up to you.
I was nervous as shit when I was in the pilot. And I thought he didn't like me. I was like, remember that? Okay, for everyone, all right, y'all, here we go.
What was the funniest part of
said, could you help me a lot? Because I could use my frustrations with you on legs.
It was like...
That's why I fell in love with you.
Yeah, thank you, Tom.
I really thought it was funny with the pilot when you were underwater and before I had to jump in the water and swim down and get you, but
this is the remix of the question.
Okay, how are we doing? He's like, I don't know. How do you want to do it? I'm like, I
progression, it just opens up so much and just helps me and it helps people listening, and I love those conversations. So when people don't open up as much, I find it hard to connect because it seems it's all surface, and that's what we watch late night television show. You know, Kimmel's amazing, but Kimmel doesn't, he's not gonna get into it with somebody. It's like 5 minutes, like, anyway, everything's just very light and surface. Maybe. But my favorite guests, well, if I have to say this, I want you guys to come on again because I love having you. Tom's been on twice. Tom's great, because we're just pals on the street, so it's easy for me to tell the stories.
I keep coming up with them.
All right, next girl. No, go. Most pets see no Tom. Chili from the day before, you know, the big Alec hot dog. Cheryl. Go ahead, last one.
Hi, my name is Gede. I come from Indonesia.
Thanks for the shirt, man.
Thank you. It's Miles and Oceans Away. This one's
your breath is great.
Small Philly is international. So you not only inspire the folks in this great country, but also in my country. So thank you so much. Me and Mark, thank you so much.
Thank you. How beautiful is that?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause.